What is up, you guys? Of course, welcome to another Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire battle with me, Scarander. And yes, that is not going to be an easy introduction to do. I'm gonna probably go into the ORAS reduction or just don't say it at all. Anyway, before going into this battle, this is definitely my first Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire battle that I'm gonna upload. Sadly, I have a Switch PC, so a much better one to adjust to the very evident doom of this mobile device to record battles. But until then, this is how it's gonna look like. And really, I don't know what happened to the quality. It looks awful. So I'm gonna get that right off the bat. I'm going to do the very best I can to find a way to restore this. Like I said, a Switch PC, and it seems like it doesn't really want to cooperate with me. And that is going to be extremely frustrating, because the quality is, while better in, you know, quality and definition, it gets a lot of pixels showing, and we can't have none of that now, can we? So keep that in mind, guys. There was definitely one good battle I had today, and I battled a lot of people today, but sadly not too many that were good, but this was definitely a battle that was genuinely good. So I was really glad to get the chance to battle somebody like this. So look at his team. He has Nidoking, Garchomp, Aggron, Tyranitar, Rhyperior, and what's it called? Swampert. So definitely a hard-hitting team, and definitely heavily weak to ground, actually. But I myself is using the Fulf team, basically, with an Alpha Steelix, or Steelix. I was so obsessed with the thought of using that, so I decided to bring it in. So I have no, like, general standard game idea. I'm just gonna go all at it here in the beginning. I'm hope for the very best, because I'm really scared of his team because of the sheer bulk that it's built on. So anyway, let's get to it. So anyway, Vileplume is definitely my anti-lead, because I have so many weaknesses to water. So I always bring Vileplume because it just catches people off guard, and it does start off with a Swampert. And I know he's not gonna stay in, so I'm gonna switch out my Solgo. Actually, I hope I'm bringing Nidoking to be able to wall me out. He's bringing the Tyranitar, and the reason that is extremely unfortunate is because of the very reason that is that I really, and I mean really, I can't take a Stone Edge if that's coming my way. So I'm just gonna go straight off the bat for my Bugra, my Hippowdon, to actually just wall him out. I mean, there is nothing he can do here. And considering it doesn't Mega Evolve, it shows me that this is not one of his Mega Pokes. We still got the Swampert and Aggron left, and Garchomp. That could be potential mega. So anyway, I go straight off the bat for Earthquake, and this Rhyperior takes it really well. I mean, it got the solid rock, and I don't really know what I was thinking here. I was so obsessed with the feeling of just showing off my Steelix that I just threw him into the battle. And he goes for the Ice Punch here, and I know an EQ is very, very, very real, and I should definitely have switched out here, but I wanted this to happen. I wanted Steelix to come in and just annihilate whatever was there. And with the Sandstorm and Sandforce, it's going to do a great amount of damage, but it doesn't do enough. And that is extremely unfortunate, because I can't take another of those pesky Earthquakes. I'm just going to go into Solgo, because I know that he's going to go for an EQ. There's no reason not to. So I'm just going to go for a Scald, finish that one off, like a Bowser name. Yeah, kind of fitting, actually. But yeah, anyway, he's gonna go out with his Swampert, and I just went for a Toxic here. I really felt that it's very likely it has Rock Slide, but then again, it could also be the Restock set. And that Ice Punch did some fair damage, enough to, you know, make me question if this were to stand in. But I was thinking that I can't really switch into anything either, and it might as well be the better just keep going at it and attack him. And the Scald does nothing, and this Rock Slide actually hurts. Like, real bad, like 2 HP left surviving bad. That was very, very lucky for me that I didn't die of that. So I'm just gonna go for rest here, because I'm thinking that he might as well go for an Ice Punch. Thinking it's a safer move, but probably is too, considering Rock Slide's shifty accuracy of 90%. Always catch you off guard with misses. So yeah, Ice Punch him, taking that. The Toxic will just whittle him down, basically, and that was basically what I went with. And I knew it's gonna be very likely him go for Rock Slide here, so my best bet is to go into Bugra, my Powdon, and wall that out, and then after that actually forcing him to attack me with a water move, and then switch it to my Steelix. Or at least that was my thought process, to be honest. So like I see you, like I see there, I took that really nicely, and I'm super proud of that. So anyway, going to Celix, and yeah, basically sacking him off here, but he goes for the Ice Punch, and I gotta be honest here, I did not expect it to not do like damage whatsoever. Steelix took that. Alphalex, you are just a beast. Oh man, oh man. But here is where my journey ends. I was definitely expecting him to go for an attack move, finish me off, and not staying in. And I, of course, back to Ice Punch or Ice Fang. Sadly, it doesn't take him out, but you know, I was just so happy with that. I really were. That was just awful how sad it was for him to go for a Swords instead of finish me off. So Alphalex, thank you. So anyway, Fulf is here, and Fulf packs the pursuit in case he tries to withdraw, which he does. So, done. So anyway, that was obviously not his Mega either, so that means that Aggron must be his Mega. So I think with Nu and that, I really just had to switch out. There was no reason for me staying in, because a Super Power won't take it out, and I can't take that retaliation back. He goes for an Head Smash. He's not, I can't stress this enough, he is not the Mega Pokemon either. Which is unfortunate, because my Lingon, my Vileplume, cannot take an Head Smash that well at all, and is easily defeated there. So anyway, going to my Zeratul, basically trying to void him out, and I am very lucky here that he doesn't hit me with a Head Smash. But then again, I don't bring him down to his HP. That is just awful. So anyway, I did actually expect myself to outspeed, which I didn't either. But I am able to finish this guy off, and the only two guys I got left is the Nidoking and Tyranitar. And the Nidoking can't take me out with a stab poison move with Sheer Force anyway. So he goes for the Earth Power, and crits. Yeah. It should basically, I did a calc, it should have done, if it was fully invested, it should have done around 60 to 70. So yes, it mattered, but who the hell cares? I still got momentum going. So I definitely know that I can take an ice beam or anything like that if he chooses to do so. But it's, switching out shows me that he's definitely scarfed. And basically, when he switched out there, I felt like, all right, I can actually do a thing here. I can sack off my Solgo, and he's gonna show me that this is his Mega Poke. So that's, oh really? You waited for that? He basically had me, like, the way he played made me so unsure on which one was the Mega Poke, which made me play very, very weirdly, because he, how to put it, he stressed me without really doing anything. I was in my own head trying to predict him all the time, and it didn't pan out as I wanted to. Anyway, Solgo is out, which is really fine, because now Fulfic can come in and finish this guy off with a retaliation, destroying that Tyranitar like a beast. You are, Fulf, never stood a chance. And the sand will still keep going, and even though the Nidoking, which I did does expect here, are scarfed, there is no way it can outspeed me because of my investment in it. So the Nidoking obviously will come in here, and I'm just gonna finish it off with a Giga Impact. Just BOOM! Bitch, BOOM! Now that is so, so powerful. Full, damn. And really, I could have, you know, swept this guy early on if I wanted to, but, you know, with it coming in with the Aggron, you definitely just gone for superpower destroying him. But I really thought it was this Mega, and by me doing that, really, really stepped up the game for me. So, yeah, it really, really was, I had good control of this battle, I really did, and I think it kind of showcased throughout that battle. Like I said, I really became my own worst enemy throughout this battle due to my misconception of my opponent. Doing those weird plays makes it really hard to, you know, recover back on. It really does. So yeah. Still, first Mega Ruby Alpha's ever battle upload. That is important. Finally. And like I said, guys, I'm really sorry about this quality. I don't know what to do. Granted, the capture card is coming and gonna save my day, but as it stands right now, I don't like it, and I need to find a way to update myself so it doesn't continue like this, even though the capture card comes in the end of December, hopefully. So anyway, guys, thank you for watching as always. Don't forget to leave a like if you like the battle, and if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, and remember, the sky is the limit. So have a good day, and take care, guys, alright? Bye.